This video shows you how to get started with mobile onboarding and provides a demo of a new hire using the app. Link time codes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. Mobile onboarding is available starting with the New York release. The application is automatically enabled when a user with the admin role activates the Enterprise Onboarding and Transitions plugin. Before you begin, you need to select a lifecycle event to use with the mobile onboarding app. You can use the one that comes with the base system or configure your own. On the same form, make sure the Display Activity Sets to Subject Person option is selected. Also verify that the Show Case to Subject Person option on the corresponding HR service is selected. Lifecycle Event Case Writers create new hire onboarding cases and work the cases here in the platform. New hires access the app on their mobile device to complete onboarding tasks. They download the mobile onboarding app from the Apple App Store or Google Play Store, open the app and add the instance you specify, and log in with the username and password you provide. The app launches, displaying the welcome screen. The top part of the screen displays a block of media, called a media section, that changes depending on the stage of the onboarding process. This one, Welcome Before Joining, displays when the onboarding case is created until one day before the new hire's start date. You can configure these sections with your own images, headlines, videos, links, and so on. The list of activity sets defined in the onboarding event appears here. Ask a question allows us to communicate with HR via these options. Notifications allows us to disable or enable push notifications from the app on our mobile device, and we log out of the app here. In our example, our new hire, Manifa, needs to complete her pre-hire to-dos by signing documents with an electronic signature. Let's see how this works. We review the document and sign or type our name, submit our signature, and that's it. After we're done with the first activity set, notification icons appear, alerting us that something's happened in the app, and we can see that we've been assigned new to-dos. The app allows us to access the next activity set. The app supports to-dos that can include forms we need to complete and submit, and forms that we need to download and complete, then upload as an attachment. We can also watch training videos and after watching, mark the to-do as complete. We completed all the to-dos in the first two activity sets. When we log into the app again, we notice that the media section at the top displays a different media section because it's one day before the new hire orientation. On the new hire's start date, the media section display changes again to greet the new employee. New hires can ask questions anytime during onboarding. The HR agent working the case views the comments in the case record under Comments and Work Notes and can respond here as well. Comments by both the new employee and the agent appear here in Notifications. After the new hire completes all to-dos and the case is closed, a final screen displays with an option to download the ServiceNow employee app. For more information, please see our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.